morning to all my friends and family, and welcome. Welcome to another cracker of a day. It's pre-sunrise, it's Wednesday, and as you can see, the moon is still up. There's a slither of a moon just above the Opera House. Actually, it looks like a sail there up there, doesn't it? How beautifully does it complement those sails of the Opera House. We've got the ferry just heading round to Manly. Don't know which ferry it is, but it's made a very early start to the day. And what we'll do is we'll go on a walk and talk, and I'll take you through a book summary again today. And the book that we'll talk about is entitled The Big Leap, and the author is Gay Hendricks. Hey, Gay Hendricks, with a book summary from entitled The Big Leap. And as you can see, I've just gotten off the train, and never ceases to amaze me. Where else in the world can you get off a train, be in a public space, and get a magnificent view like this? The flags on the Harbour Bridge are listless. There's hardly a breeze out there. It's flat, it's beautiful. So let's get moving, and we'll chat away as we're going, and I'll head round, as I usually do, to the Museum of Contemporary Art. So let's go through a few of these points from this book, The Big Leap. And I've got to tell you, there's some pretty awesome and interesting material that comes out, and we always seem to learn. Always seem to learn something new and pick up something new every day, which is one of the beauties of being curious and being a life learner. But the great point that I came across in this book is that people seem to resist happiness. Think about that one. I'll just tap out. People seem to resist happiness. How sad is that? And you see it all the time with our friends, family, work peers. There are people who just seem to go through life needing permission to be happy. Or if they're happy, they'll do whatever it takes just to sabotage that happiness, or to temper that happiness through fear that they don't deserve to be happy. So the author makes a very good point, and I've never thought about this before, but how many times have been to social functions, and you tend to see it in families. There are certain families that will just sit at the table long-faced and not move all night, not get up to dance, not to socialize. They'll just sit there ticking a box with some resistance, some powerful resistance to happiness. And you always think to yourself, but why? You know, you're here, it's a party, the social the social responsibility or our duty is to socialize, have fun, or create fun for each other, and not to be just too serious and sitting down long-faced as if you need somebody to come over and give you permission to enjoy yourself and to have a good time. But this is where the author talks about something and says that there are people out there who are just not comfortable or skilled at being happy. What a concept that is. Maybe there are people out there who have not learned how to be happy, because of the family environments that they're in, because of some rules that they've got, or they've come across, or they've inherited from other people, that in order to be happy, you need to have this, 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 and this happening in your life. But I guess the author encourages people to release the handbrake, and just allow yourself to indulge, allow yourself to be happy and to enjoy your life. And she talks about something else which is interesting. She talks about fear. That a lot of people live in fear and don't think that they're worthy of being happy. But a really, really interesting point, as I said, another point, another learning from this book, which I've never considered before. But she says that fear is a breathless excitement. When you're undergoing excitement, but you fail to breathe, or you fail to breathe effectively.
And what it
does is it causes you to tense up, to freeze up, and to not be able to fully express yourself and connect with your environment around you. And this thought, or this idea, came from Gestalt therapy theory, where they say the difference between being excited, the difference between being excited, the difference between feeling elated, ecstatic, is the fact that you're not breathing properly. So a simple lesson from this book is that if you want to feel better about yourself, if you want to feel better about a situation, just breathe. Learn how to breathe, take deep breaths, and you'll often see it when people are about to do a performance or go on stage or do some public speaking. They take some deep breaths,
and those deep breaths are
guaranteed to get you started, get you focused, get you going, and get you pumping. So a nice little lesson from this book and from Gestalt therapy.
Focus on your breathing. If you're not feeling comfortable,
if you're not feeling confident about something, someone, a situation, then breathe it out. Learn how to breathe.
The second point
that came out of the book is the concept of limited happiness.
Some people have
a throttle or a handbrake on their happiness. And it's called an upper limit mindset, where for some reason along the way they have taught themselves, or they've learnt from other people, that they don't deserve to be happy. They don't deserve to be happy, and if they are happy, it's only fleeting, and sooner or later something will happen to make them unhappy again. And as we said, or as we alluded to, it's a mindset that you can manage and that you can change.
Because it's a form of self-sabotage.
Some people are just wired, or have wired themselves, to reduce their happiness, to sabotage their happiness.
And I don't know why
or how it's come about, but they just feel guilty if they're happy.
And they try and
mask it at every opportunity, and to basically cool themselves down or chill themselves out, so they don't get to experience true happiness. The other point from this book, the key point, is to let go of any useless worries. And useless worries, according to the author, worrying about things that you can't change. A lot of people are overwhelmed, a lot of people are preoccupied, constantly preoccupied with worries. Worrying about bloody what? They just worry there. I guess they're also described as being worry warts. Constantly worrying about everything that's happening around them. Worrying about the future, worrying about the past, but missing out on the present.
So
the author suggests, don't worry about things you can't change, don't worry about things you can't influence, and don't worry about things you can't alter. Just take action. Just move them out of the back of your head, move them out of your mind, and just take action and get on with your life, because you're going to spend your life worrying about things you can't change, and then you're going to look back and worry that you didn't live the life that you were meant to live, and you'll just be disappointed, empty and frustrated, and basically not be fun to be around, and just be a burden and a weight on all those other people who you touch in your life. Because we all have a responsibility. We've got a responsibility to be a source of joy and a source of empowerment to not only ourselves but to the people around us. And if people see you at a function and you're long-faced, thinking, drifting away, then you're not going to be the sort of person people are going to want to hang out with. Simple as that. And the last point of this book is that you need to stop complaining, and to do a complaining audit on yourself and the people around you, because by complaining, all you're doing is just magnifying and growing your problems, making them bigger and worse than what they are. And complaining is not going to solve anything, because complaining is just basically labeling and highlighting and amplifying what your problem is. You know what your problem is, then sort it out, fix it up, do something about it, and don't sit there complaining, and don't let people around you continue to complain over and over again about problems. So the bottom line is that we need to take responsibilities for all the things that we have in our lives, and we need to deal with the issues, because if we don't deal with the issues that we have, then they're going to grow, and we're going to suffer the consequences. So the author suggests that we enforce a complaint diet, that we decide to no longer complain, and to not allow people around us to complain as well, because their complaints bring us down, and they impact not only themselves but also the people around them. So try and go on a complaint diet is the word that comes from this book. And the last one is to stop projecting your problems onto everybody else. Stop the blame game. And because what you're doing is you're bringing everybody else down around you. You're bringing yourself down, and you're also impacting the people around you. So a lot of wonderful, wonderful lessons from this book. The book which is entitled The Big Leap. And it's a call to action for each and every one of us to do the most we can, to generate joy and to live the best possible life that we can, and to give ourselves permission to be happy. Let go of the problems, let go of the worry, and know that you are worthy. You are worthy to be happy, and you can be happy all the time. Now, there's not a time limit on happiness. No, you don't just have to be happy 5 minutes or 10 minutes and then get back to your serious self. You know, happiness is a lifestyle. You can choose to be happy all the time. You can choose to be a source of joy all the time. So it's up to you to take it on board. Anyway, thank you very much for joining me on this episode of Jim's 5 a.m. Club. As you can see, there are so many lessons. There is so much positive material out there that can help us grow and develop and get through our days. Let's finish off with a positive affirmation. I'm alive, I am well, and I feel absolutely great. To my friends and family, stay connected, stay relevant, and most importantly, be happy. Be happy and know that you're worthy of happiness, and release that handbrake, and change your face, learn to breathe when you're fearful, because through through breathing, you will change the sensation from fear to excitement. So I guess we'll leave it there for today. I'm off to work. It's going to be a cracker of a sunrise, which will be popping up over the next maybe 10-15 minutes. But thank you once again for joining me
on this beautiful morning. I love getting up
early. I love kicking off the day. And every day is a new start for all of us. So let's make the most of today. And if you can make the most of your today, then we can all be better and more and happier when we next meet. Yasas, take care. And until we meet again, ciao from me. Bye.